Welcome back to another video of XB. Today we have the opportunity to review the Gardena electric lawnmower PowerMax 1600/37, where the 1600 stands for the power and the 37 stands for the cutting width of the mower. I received the box and I was actually quite surprised that the lawnmower could fit into it. This lawnmower also has a mulching function, which I didn't know what it was until now. But more on that later. When opening the box, you see we have a booklet inside. But this booklet doesn't give any more information on how to install the lawnmower. They probably assume that everyone finds it self-explanatory on how to assemble a lawnmower. Just to give you a clue, I seriously sweated a bit during installation, which took me some effort for me as a two left-handed gadgeteer. Everything was neatly wrapped in plastic or even with soft foil. The lawnmower itself was fairly light and easy to carry with one hand. I got the opportunity to test this lawnmower via reviewclub.nl. It's a website where you can register for free, fill out a small survey and hope you get selected to test a device. Thank you, reviewclub.nl. This is the mulching lid, which I will give more info about it at the end of the video. Then we have the sides of the grass catcher bench, which consists of two parts of hardened plastic, good for a sloppy 45 liters of grass. The blue top lid of the grass catcher bench is equipped with a neat handle to transport your bench very easily. Further, we install the telescopic and folding handles. This makes it easy to use the lawnmower for many people of different heights. First, you slide the handles into the small tubes. These are provided with pre-drilled holes where you can easily screw it in after sliding the handle tube. Then we come to the grass catcher bench. This one is a little more difficult to put together because it's hardened plastic, which has a very smooth surface. As well as the shape, it's just not easy to handle. Or you could say, I just have two short arms. In any case, you can push hard on the plastic because it is precisely then that the clamps on the inside attach themselves better so that it forms a nice whole bench. The top lid also has the same clamps on the inside. It is best to grab it at the sides so you can push the bench very well. And you can push it very well together. Here is a close-up of the clamps on the inside of the bench when assembled. The harder you push it, the better it sticks together. When the bench is assembled, we are ready to attach it on the lawnmower itself and see the final result. In a few seconds, we look at the underside of the lawnmower and we see the precision ground dual edge blades. These blades should provide a very good mowing result. When we look up for dual edge online, we see that the blades are made of double hardened steel and then are powder coated. Keep in mind that it is always best to replace the blades after a certain period. Currently, they are available as a spare set for just about 20 euros. Afterwards, we see the socket to attach the extension cord. The cable is easy to connect. I personally would choose that the device itself has a cable of about 1 meter in length. On my old lawnmower, the contact broke after a few years. The grounding pin sank back. A built-in cable could prevent this, but hey, that's just my opinion. I would like to quickly return to the mulching unit, which is included. Mulching is a function on your lawnmower where the cut grass is finely shredded. The layer of grass clippings protect the grass roots from heat and release nutrients to the soil. This way you can fertilize your garden in a natural way. Not recommended if you have just dug weeds or if the grass is wet. To obtain this function, first remove the grass catcher bench and place a mulching unit into the hole. By the way, this is a function that lawnmower robots often use. Finally, we get to the part where we see the Gardena at work, as well as my old faithful friend, the Viking, which I like to feature on video as well. This one really did its best, but every era comes to an end and must be replaced at some point. Here you see the Gardena in comparison with the Viking. First, I will show you the Viking at work. The Viking is also an electric lawnmower, but a few years older. Notice the heavy breathing sound it makes while mowing. Then we have the Gardena. It makes a more muffled sound, more like a vacuum cleaner. This secretly also makes it good to mow on Sundays, which I did on the video. In my humble opinion, an electric lawnmower is a very good replacement for a conventional lawnmower. But only one thing bothers me. You always have to take into account the cable. Unlike petrol, as in the past, which you always have to add or make sure you still have petrol at the house, and usually you ran out of petrol at such a critical moment when you were on a hurry. Also, a lawnmower equipped with a battery is also very useful. But you should not forget that with a battery, you cannot always mow for very long. You usually need a second battery for extended use. And the power decreases as the battery strength gets weaker. Just to keep this info in mind. In conclusion, the Gardena PowerMax 1600/37 electric lawnmower is a very solid device. If you're not as handy as me, or if you are also too left-handed, it may take a while to put it together, but it will be a quite a fun and instructive process. And keep in mind, you really can't go wrong during the installation process. The 45-liter grass catcher bench is definitely recommended for gardens up to about 500 square meters. The sound of 80 decibels is certainly doable.